I look forward to the opportunity to debate with my fellow leaders about the plans that we have and the vision we each have for the future of this country. I know this is going to be an election campaign filled with moments of robust exchanges as we move forward.
That was Prime Minister Justin Trudeau responding to Conservative leader Andrew Scheer's accusation that the Prime Minister is hiding from debates. The Liberal Party has not yet confirmed if Trudeau will participate in two sort of non-official debates being hosted by Maclean's and a Munk debate on City TV. We're back with the power panel. Rachel Curran, Andrew Thompson, David Hertel. Sorry, the Munk debates are separate. The City TV debate is the other one, the Maclean's one. Rachel, I'll start with you. So the Prime Minister was directly asked if, you know, are you going to participate? And that he didn't answer, obviously, directly. What do you think the calculation is strategically from the perspective of, I mean, opposition parties want to participate, we've heard, in these debates. We know they've confirmed their attendance. What do you think the strategy is from the Liberals' perspective?
Well, look, I mean, I think they thought the only debates they'd have to deal with were the ones set up by the Debate Commission in October, and now there are two others that are being set up by third parties. I think they know their guy, Justin Trudeau, isn't very good on his feet. He's not very good unless he's carefully scripted, and he has a habit of making terrible gaffes that are embarrassing and will set him back during the campaign. So I suspect they want to reduce his exposure in that kind of forum as much as they possibly can. So I think they're trying to figure out what sort of hit they'll take, political hit they'll take from keeping him away from those debates and seeing whether they can manage that.
He did just to pick up on that and quickly ask you a follow-up. I mean, he was sort of, that was the expectation set of him in the last set of debates as well, and he did sort of outperform them. He had some positive moments that ended up changing. You know, why would the calculation, you think, be different this time? Is it because it's more about him, more about his record?
Well, absolutely. I mean, he cannot run on his record now. As we've seen, he's not running on his record. You know, 2015 was a very different context. He was the new guy. It was time for a change. People were looking for something new and different. You know, in this context now, in 2019, he's got a record that in many cases looks pretty unimpressive. He's not going to want to be up there on a stage being questioned about it by potentially three other opposition parties.
David, what would your advice be? Go participate to the Liberal camp. Participate in those debates or stick to the official one?
I would stick to the official ones. If I were an advisor, I mean, I'm shocked. An incoming prime minister doesn't want to do more debates. I agree with Rachel's main point here. I mean, there's no upside for Justin Trudeau to do more debates than he has to. There's only potential for breaking even or a downside. So you want to avoid as many downsides as possible. Plus, the campaign isn't really started yet. Well, it's not started at all. It's not even officially started.
Just feels and like
so,
it has.
Yeah, it is. No, but for us, it has. Yeah. But officially speaking, it hasn't started. So I think the Maclean's debate was scheduled for September 12th. Now, if we understand that the Prime Minister won't drop the writ until after the Manitoba election, which are September 10th, then, I mean, if he could be making the announcement on September 12th. Mm-hmm. So do you debate the day you announce the election officially? So it's part also of the strategic communications plan that the Liberals have, that actually the Maclean's debate may just not be possible the way the Liberals want to play this with the actual start of the campaign.
I think from a strategic point of view, that makes sense, Andrew. But from a principled point of view, I mean, this is what they criticized Stephen Harper for. Back in 2015, right? Refusing to participate in debates. Do people care, do you think, or what do you think?
Well, there is a risk that you look like you're running from your record, and it allows the Conservatives to certainly put that forward. I would differ a little bit with what Rachel has said in that I actually think that Justin Trudeau is quite effective in these debate formats, and he's demonstrated through his town halls that he can be quite an effective communicator with, you know, in that type of an environment. So I don't think that's you know, weighing as much in terms of the strategy. I suspect one of the challenges that they have, it goes back to this discussion we were having in the last segment, is how do you present this election as being a choice between Liberals and Conservatives? And he needs to make sure that that keeps Singh and the NDP and May and the Greens fully marginalized. The problem when you're on a debate is all four leaders are essentially equal. And he used this very effectively in 2015, as you'll remember, to catapult from third to first. So he'll be, I think, wanting to make sure that he minimizes that opportunity for anybody else to, you know, follow his playbook.
That's an interesting point, Rachel. What do you think?
Yeah, that's a good point. You know, as the Prime Minister, he's going to be the focus of attacks from everyone else on that stage. And that also puts him, I think, at a real disadvantage. But you know, to the point that he's okay at town halls, so he's going to be good at this too. This is a very different forum. I mean, debates are an intellectual exchange. They're fast moving. They're fast paced. I'm not convinced that this is a forum in which he really excels. He's not. The Liberals would much rather have him out there interacting with ordinary Canadians. Mm-hmm. You know, kind of doing his kind of charismatic thing. You know, in a forum like this, that's much more formal. I don't think he'll do well at all.
Well, it's different. I mean, the calculation is a bit not calculation, that's the wrong word, but the characterization is a bit different also, David, because he like, there was less to lose in the last one, right? This is, and it's, and the focus wasn't entirely on his record. It was on a different government's record. But at the same time, like Andrew says, I mean, the expectation was built in primarily by the Conservatives that he was going to be so terrible that he really did outperform it.
He did outperform, but he didn't have a record to run on.
Yeah.
So he was the upstart. And also, if we want to go back to 2015, one, there was this will for change, and also the NDP imploded. Remember, at the beginning of the 2015 campaign, we were looking at possibly an NDP government.
Yes, I remember. I remember. I do remember that, David. Thank you.
And the Liberals were clearly in third place. And Justin Trudeau was able to embody change and create that coalition we were talking about in the previous segment. So now, do you want to add more chances about talking about SNC, talking about, you know, some of the failed promises, Trans Mountain, all these issues that you don't want necessarily to put too much focus on it. And also, you give a chance for others to shine. Like, for example, I mean, in Quebec, for example, the Greens are polling higher than the NDP right now. And so if you have a lot of debates for the Greens, maybe your people are going to take a second look. And Justin Trudeau needs, as we said, he needs that coalition to rebuild that coalition of progressive voters to keep power.
Just have a few seconds left. Last word to you, Andrew.
Well, I think that is the calculation. Is he's wanting to set this up as a referendum as to whether, you know, it's better him or Andrew Scheer, you know, whatever his agenda is versus this scary secret one that supposedly Andrew Scheer is harboring. And that doesn't work when you have a multi-party democracy. And I really think that this is what he's, you know, what the Liberals are trying to do is frame the debates, frame the overall conversation going into the campaign around that. And Okay. That's, I think, what the calculation is.
Okay, I got to leave it there. But thank you so much to all three of you this evening. Thanks to Rachel Curran, Andrew Thompson, and David Ertel, our power panel. Hi, I'm Vashi Capellos, host of Power in Politics. See more of our show by subscribing to the CBC News channel or click the link for another video. Thanks for watching.